Want a reason to go to the movies? Well, Guy Ritchie's got six for you, all starring in the gangster comedy, The Gentlemen.
In the jungle, the only way a lion survives by being the king.
McConaughey plays an American drug kingpin, and everyone else is either scheming, bribing, or trying to blackmail him.
We have all of these smooth criminals and these gangsters, but who's the real boss of this movie? Boom.
That's right, it takes a real lady to school these gentlemen.
I mean, I came onto this job with, you know, 3 days' notice.
They say the one thing about Michael, your character, his one weak link is his wife. Mm. So I'm just curious, what's that Achilles heel for you all in your personal lives?
It would be my weak link or my strongest link. Rosalind was the one thing that was, okay, that's a game changer. If you cross that line and do anything that could harm my wife, I'm gonna kill you.
Oh, but I mean for Matthew.
That's what I was talking about.
Oh, okay. Sorry, you said... Same.
No, but yeah, no, I was talking about for Mickey and Rosalind.
Yes.
But on that note, I'll hand it over and say you can twitch names out in what I just said.
Yeah. What is that thing for you guys?
Existential blackness whenever I'm not occupied with something.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Hugh?
Well, yes, I had that once, but I think I'd had too much absinthe. You know, that drink which is banned.
As time has progressed in your career, you've talked about taking roles specifically for the experience. What was the experience with this one, with The Gentleman?
For myself, it was to live out a childhood dream. Growing up with Guy's films that he did that were so iconic in UK culture.
It was just fun to inhabit that world and be one of those Guy Ritchie sort of archetype, you know, bad guys.
Anytime a movie comes out, right, you do interviews like this, and then usually people take one line and that's everywhere. And Hugh, I think the line that I've been seeing is that you don't like making movies.
Well, I've been saying that for 36 years.
So that is true?
I agree with Charlie. I like the prep. It's just merely that the technology of filming hasn't really changed for 100 years. And so, as you know, you've been on lots of film sets. It's really slow. You're shooting 2 minutes of the film a day, over and over again from different angles.
You know, we see all these smooth-talking criminals. Out of this actual cast, who is most likely to smooth-talk their way out of a brush with the law?
Hugh.
Hugh.
Yeah, Hugh'd be good at that.
Okay.
He'd confuse the hell out of him.
The film ends perfectly set up for a sequel. I'm just gonna get straight to it. Would you do a Dazed and Confused sequel?
Oh, it's all lined up, for sure. It'd be great to revisit. That was the first film I ever did.
You can catch The Gentleman in theaters now.